Welcome to School of Civil Engineering. As we have started a ETAPS tutorial series, and in this lecture we will learn that how can we draw our grid system according to our building plan. So let's start. This is our beam column layout. So here I have defined the beam size and column size. I am using two types of column for here. In previous video I have discussed about that, and they have one column which a center point are not in the intersection of two beam, and here also they have one. And now we'll draw this grid system in ETAPS. So to draw this grid system, we have to at first learn about a thing that we'll take the distance from one grid to another grid is the center to center distance of beam. Also here I have taken that 11 feet 3 inch, here center to center distance, again from here center to center distance, here again center to center distance. I have to take that because if we take the distance from column to column, then it will be difficult to draw the beam. That's why we'll draw our grid system according to center to center. And in this here also the distance is 16 feet from center to centers, from that beam to that beam, and here also 8 feet from that beam to that beam. This is a quite easy plan. So we'll draw that. Now we'll draw that. So let's start. Before that, we have to open our ETAPS 2016. Let's open it. And if you don't see my previous video, you can watch that from my previous lecture. The link are given in description about this full ETAPS tutorial. And if you have any problem in ETAPS, in this ETAPS tutorial, or if you don't understand anything from here, you should contact to me. Okay, so first of all we'll open our existing file. I mean, in previous lecture I have told you that we'll use one ETAPS work. I mean, we'll design one building here. So here that is our previous work. Open. This grid system was our default grid system. And the one thing is, if you have a grid system, if you have a plan previously, then at the starting time you can take your grid system. I have discussed about that in my previous video. So from here I will draw it manually. I mean, I'll just edit it. So first of all, go to edit here, edit history and grid system, here grid 1, click here modify. So from here we'll modify that. First of all, we have to click here display grid as a spacing. We can change the bubble size, well, not change that. So from here first of all we'll change that grid, and here from AutoCAD we're seeing that they have A, B, C, D. I mean, 4 grid in X direction and 3 grid in Y direction. So from here A, B, C, D, our first distance 11 feet 3 inch, and then 20 feet, and then 7 feet 9 inch. So first of all, we'll provide here 11 feet and 3 inch. When you input that value, you will face some problem. Suppose you have the value of 11 feet 3 inch. So first of all, you have to given here 11, then feet sign, then 3, and press shift and inch sign. Then 11 feet 3 inch, and then 20 feet, then 9 feet, so 7 feet 9 inch. 7 feet 9 shift inch 9 inch, and it will be 0. Last grid will be 0 because the value of 11.2 feet, refer that this is the distance between A to B grid, and the distance 20 refer that the distance between B to C, and C refer the distance between C to D. And now we'll draw here, we'll give the value of y direction. So here in y direction there have 1 2 3 1 2 3, but here there have 4. We'll delete 1 here, 1, and from our AutoCAD grid system we are seeing that there have 1 2 and 3, but in etabs first of all have 3 2 1. That's why we'll give here 3, we'll give her 1, and we'll give her 2. So our grid system will be 3 2 1. Yeah, here you are seeing that the value is 1 2 3 according to our etabs. 1 2 3. Now we'll provide the distance here. So first of all, we have to provide the value of 3 2 2 16, then 8. And then we have to give here value as from 3 3 2. In the distance 3 2, we know that here 3 and 2, its value is 8, and from 2 1 2 1, its value is 16, and here from 1 there will be 0. So according to it, 16 8. You have to input that value here 1 2 2 16 and 2 3 it's 8. You can see here from I've told you that the value of 3 define that this is the distance between 2 2 3 2 2 3, and the value of 2 in grid 2, the value 16, refers that this is the distance between 2 to 1. So, and 1 refers that they have no line after 1. So this is our data we have provided as our grid system, and here you can maximize or minimize your bubble size. I mean, they have 16 if we want to, and give her 30. It will be a small, let it 30. From here, quick start rectangular grid, you can start a rectangular grid here. You can add general grid, and also I'm giving that for all stress, the reference point and reference plane. We'll learn it later. We'll draw a star. Okay, go okay. you are seeing that our data going here 11.25 20 7.75 feet, and here 8 and 16 feet. So that is today. In our next video we'll learn that how we'll draw our building in etabs, and then we'll assign our load in building only for the dead load and live load, and then we'll analyze that building, and then we'll analyze that building for earthquake load, and then we'll analyze this building for wind load, and after that we'll finally analyze that building and also design that building. Okay, thank you very much. Stay connected.